What's up, guys? Welcome to another video, and today we're going to be discussing all the homunculus trees. So I'm doing this guide so that it will help people decide on what homunculus to build, because each homunculus can be built in a different way, right? And they can fulfill very different roles. So there's no real best homunculus because they're all like fairly equal in terms of their usefulness. I mean, there's some abilities that I do not recommend, but for the most part, they can cover a range of areas of the game, and it really depends on what area you need help with the most, right? So I'm gonna go through all this, like all the upgraded skills, and explain what my thoughts on those are. I've used quite a few of these abilities, so I can give you some, just my own opinions on those. So first off, we're just looking at we should look at the tree first. So first off, we start off with a default skill, and then it upgrades into like two different types of skills, right? And then this third column is actually the second base skill, and then they branch out to two different abilities, right? Or like two different upgrades for it, and then they then further branch out to the third abilities, which you can only pick. Like, let's say this one you can only pick if you go down this route, right? You can just follow the trees here, and you can see what you can pick based on that. All right, so first off, I'm gonna look at it from like a tree perspective, because the trees t tend to specialize in different areas, like on that path, right? So first off, on the top path, we have the upgraded version of the first skill, which is Flame Ray Flood. So this one is an attack speed scaling ability. So think of it similar to Fiomar's first ability. It doesn't do as much damage, but it does add a continuous damage on it, which is it's nice to have. But I mean, the main thing is the damage. You'll probably expect like a little bit less than Fiomar's, but it's still respectable for a first skill. So there's that one, and then the second skills, you have a choice between these two. So the first one at the top, we have the flood version of Flame Magic Bullet. So this one, the basic one, does defense break, and flood adds the attack speed scaling. So single target defense break and attack speed scaling damage, pretty good overall ability, right? Now you compare this to the alternative, which is accelerate. Now accelerate increases your own attack bar by 50% after you use this. Now, if you're making a violent homunculus, I do not recommend you to use this ability, because if you use this ability, gain attack bar, and then you proc violent, then you just waste the attack bar because you go back down to zero afterwards. So in general, I think I would always pick flood, because it's just scaling of attack speed, which is already a nice damage boost already, and it's good in all situations, right? It's never bad. Whereas sometimes accelerate, doesn't perform to its maximum potential, right? Because of violent. If you're running it on non-violent, then I guess you could pick that one if you want. But if you're going for speed scaling on the first ability already, I think it makes sense to pick speed scaling on the second ability. So yeah, that's my recommendation for this path at least. Now, for the third abilities along this path, we have at the very top, Burn Soul. This is a single target burst damage ability, which scales off your own attack speed and also your like the target. So the damage is kind of similar to like a Squall Chimera. It doesn't do as much damage as Squall does, but it's still quite respectable, and you can expect to one-shot most Syros and stuff like that, even through will runes, depending on how tanky they make the Syros, right? If it's just like a standard Nuka Syros on will, maybe 20k HP maximum, you should be able to one-shot it with this ability through will. So it's good against that sort of team, right? If you just want to single target snipe something in Guild Wars offense, this is the skill that you would like to pick. In arena, it's not as good, because single target burst damage is good on wind units and water units. The reason being, usually the most of the store units are water units. For example, Rina and Camilla, you want single target damage against those to burst them down. And you know, obviously the fire homunculus doesn't really fulfill that role. There's not that many like fire and wind units that you would really care about on a store defense, right? At least not that something that you can probably pick a wind unit that can already do that already. But if you need something for that purpose, you could. But there's not that many wind store units, apart from maybe I guess a retesh, but it's not that common on that type of defense. So this is more of a Guild Wars offense build, in my opinion. This is also decent for things like raids. I used to use this in the fire raid, mostly just for like single target burst damage to do as much damage on the groggy stage as possible, and it worked pretty well for. So then the alternative is Flaming Thunder. So Flaming Thunder is an AoE instead of attack speed scaling on the opponent. It still scales with your own attack speed, so you can basically build the Homunculus to speed to scale off speed for all three abilities if you go along this path, and I would recommend that because it would just make sense when you're trying to optimize it with runes, right? So this one is an AoE, you know, fire damage ability, which is a very rare sort of role, right? Pretty much the main one, like, that people use for fire AoE is Syros, and obviously it's a nat fight that you need to, you know, RNG and pray to the gods that you'll get him. If you don't have him, this is a very good alternative if you happen to need a fire AoE unit. You can generally get by with like a water and a wind AoE. It has, you know, it covers all the elements by its like on that fight for that setup already. But if you really want a fire AoE nuker, I would recommend to build it this way. So that's good for like AO and also Guild Wars offense if you're running a cleave team. Now going down to the bottom path, we have Flame Raid Chain, right? So this is the first ability that gets upgraded, and it changes it to a multi-hit, right? It still does continuous damage, which is very nice for obviously Necro. It can also be used for the Dark Raid Beast too, if you're like trying to stack a lot of multi-hits to help free your the unit that gets imprisoned. And then I would say this is the path to go along. The continuous damage doesn't help on raid base, but it's mostly for the multi-hits. And obviously for Necro, continuous damage still ticks before the boss gets the shield back, so it's actually pretty good in helping kill the boss quicker. So this is already starting like to look like a Necro path. And then you have a choice between Bran for the second ability, right? So by default, it already decreases attack speed, and then you're adding the branding effect on top of that for this ability. So two debuffs in one ability, which is quite nice, especially for R5. All right, it's decent also for Raid Beasts as well, because it's an instance of branding that you can add. Attack speed slow helps, I believe. The extent to which attack speed slow helps on the Groggy stage is it's hard to determine, but it should help because you know it the boss should be, or like the Groggy stage should last a bit longer when it's slow. Now then the alternative for the second skill is Chain. Now this ability is better for Necro. If you're building the Homunculus to help speed up your Necro run, I would go for this one. This is a reliable attack speed slow, right? It's on a 3-turn cooldown, 2-turn duration, and it's a multi-hit ability too. So if you're building for Necro, it's a good idea to obviously stack, you know, multiple multi-hits to make the unit reliable. So that's why things like Zebralta, even though not a lot of end game players use it, but it's good for early game because it has a lot of multi-hits on all three abilities. This Homunculus is like serves a similar role. Okay, so I would recommend this because it's got the multi-hit portion, but the branding one is still fine, right? If you have plenty of multi-hits on your team, you can go this one if you want. So it's up to you. Now, for the third abilities, you have a choice between Eruption, right? So now this one is similar to Zhaolin third skill, and it scales off multiple harmful effects on the target. So this is obviously very good for raid base and also R5. That's probably the main areas I would use this on, because for those fights it's all about the debuffs, and if you're stacking a lot of debuffs on the boss, then this is gonna do a lot of damage to it. And the alternative is Flame Explosion. So this one is a multi-hit and also does continuous damage. So I guess it's similar to the first skill, but overall it will do more damage. And also because the continuous damage is a max harmful effect rate compared to the first skill, which is only 50%. I believe it might be 65% when it's upgraded. Oh no, this one's only 50% when it's upgraded. So this Flame Explosion, obviously it's good for Necro. Pretty much that's all it's good for. If you go down like go down the full bottom path, that's a Necro build. But if you're farming for Homunculus, you probably already have like a good Necro team. So unless you specifically want to really speed up your team and you want to try to fit in the Fire Homunculus for that, then I don't really recommend that. I feel that it's more useful to have the PvP version up this path. Or you can also do like a raid build, which is like along this path. So you pick up Branding and Eruption. That's another alternative raid path as well. Now for the Water Homunculus, so along the top path here, you have Purify for the Frost Ray, which is the first ability. So this one adds a buff removal, right, to the first ability. By default, the first ability has the freeze effect. So yeah, this ability, one turn buff removal, is actually pretty good for giants and dragons, because giants has an attack buff, so you can remove that. Dragons has the immunity buff, so you can remove that with this ability. So this is suitable to put on to revenge as well. So when the boss attacks you and it has the buff on, you can hopefully proc and remove that too. I believe the buff removal is also max harmful effect rate, so I think that's it's a pretty decent first skill. Now, on the second skill upgrades, we have a choice between Fluctuate. So this one is an AoE defense break. So by default, it will defense break for 2 turns. The Fluctuate just adds the AoE portion of it. So this is good for, I would say this is good for PvP, because AoE defense break is always nice. But mostly I would say it's good for trash wave clearing. So you could use this on like things like dragons or giants and help defense break the trash waves and allow your other AoE nukers to kill them quicker, right? Like pretty much straight afterwards. Especially since Galleon has a cooldown, so he won't always have time to loot turn one, right? So sometimes it helps to have the Homunculus help clear the waves. It's also good for fodder farming if you care about that. By now you probably shouldn't care that much about it, but in case you want a really fast fodder farmer, this can help you do that too. Now the alternative is Amplify. So this one is a single target damage that does the standard defense break, but the additional effect is damage scaling in proportion to max HP. So this is good for dragons on the boss, and also for giants on the boss too, because they have very high health. So scaling off max HP for damage is really good on that. So I would liken this to something like a Spectra second skill, which also does defense break at the same time. So it's a pretty good boss killing ability. It doesn't help as much for trash waves, but they're both good in their own ways for that sort of purpose. Now for the third abilities, you have a choice between Ice Explosion. So this one, I would liken this to something like a Tasha, which reduces cooldown when you kill something. Tasha will reset the cooldown as long as it kills one unit. This one will reset for each unit, or like it will decrease by one turn for each unit you kill. So again, this is another good trash wave clearing sort of ability. or for something like fodder farming. I have seen fodder farming, fodder farming ability, Homunculus on friends list that used ice explosion for that purpose, in addition to fluctuate magic bullet. So you have two strong AoEs that can, basically just wipe the waves each turn. Additionally, you can also use it for something like, if you care about it, TOA racing, because you can clear, you can kill all five units and basically reset the ability as well for the next wave. So you could do that too. It's like a poor man's Tisha. Well, not really poor man's, but it's in like a water version of Tisha. Now the alternative is Three's Mine. So this is a single target ability that does max HP damage and also resets attack bar. So I guess you could liken it to Beretta's Turbulence and also Spectre's second ability too. So both of their second abilities combine in one. Reset attack bar and do very high damage. So I used to use this for my Dragon's speed team. It made it a lot safer because I'm reducing the attack bar, like it's an additional unit that can reduce attack bar. And it's also very good when they have like when the boss has ov like attack bar overflow, because usually your Vert is gonna overflow your units and then allow them to move. And if the boss is overflowed, he'll pretty much move straight up after it, right? There's nothing that will stop him from moving. But if your Homunculus does the reset, while he's overflowed, he'll reset back to zero, and then it buys you a lot more time before he hits, before he actually hits you. So this is a good boss killing ability. You can also use it for TOA hard if you want to. It's like an additional turbulence that you can use, which also does pretty decent damage. So yeah, that's the top half for Water Homunculus. So the bottom half you have Fluctuate for the first ability. So it's an AoE, which also freezes. This is good for TOA, right? It's an AoE freeze chance. I think it's very strong for that. You can also use it for fodder farming if you want, but I figure it's not as good as the top path, which has ice explosion. Now for the second abilities, you have a choice between absorb, and the this one does so attacks all enemies and absorbs the attack bar with a 50% chance or 65% chance when it's max skilled. And the alternative is chain. So chain is decrease attack bar 30% each time it attacks with a 50% chance. I think this one is personally I prefer this one. I feel it's a bit, it will reduce attack bars a lot more. So it's really good for TOA, right? And whereas this one, absorb attack bar, I feel that if you're trying to absorb attack bar, you want it to be reliable so that you can reliably gain a new turn, basically, right? Because if you attack four or more enemies, and if this was max harmful effect rate, you could gain 120% attack bar back, and then you can have another turn. So you would generally want to build your Homunculus based around that sort of idea. But because it's not reliable, it's not, I wouldn't try to build up towards that purpose. So I would recommend you to use this one for the like more, I guess it's a bit more reliable on decreasing the attack bar, because it's also hitting them multiple times. Now you have a choice for the third abilities on either Frostwind, which is a very simple guaranteed freeze or barring accuracy check. So it's like basically like a Tyrone third skill, and Ice Mist. So Ice Mist does continuous damage similar to Beretta, but it has an additional effect where it will do more continuous damage if there's already harmful effects on the unit. To me, I feel that Ice Mist is a bit better for TOA hard, and people are generally going to be missing crowd control more than they're going to be missing continuous damage, because you can already get Beretta, and Beretta is enough to just clear, the waves, right? As long as you have enough crowd control, Beretta will dot everything up for you. So I think I would recommend you to use Frostwind, but alternatively you can use Ice Mist if you have a lot of AoE stuns and stuff already. You can do that too. Now for the Wind Homunculus, we have the top path. You have the chain on Shock Ray for the first ability. So this one will do a multi-hit for disturb HP recovery, right? So HP block, and it's also a multi-hit. So there's multiple chances to block heals. So that's pretty good for Necro, and also the block heals is very good for raids. Okay. Now the second ability, you have a choice between branding. By default, it does attack speed slow, so similar to the fire one. It's actually exactly the same as the fire version of it. And the alternative is the same for the fire ability, actually. Multiple hits and attack speed slow. So this one is like a necro ability, and the branding one is for raids. Right, you can go either way. I feel that if you're gonna go for the Wind Homunculus, you're probably gonna build it for raids, but you can use it also secondarily for Necro, because you'll soon see like he also has multi hits on the third ability. So for the first third ability, you have Whirling Wind. I actually was asked on stream recently whether I prefer Whirling Wind or Magic Bullet Madness. So just to explain what the skills do first. Whirling Wind does defense break and branding, right? Also, it's also a multi-hit, and it does more damage at the like for the last hit. So what it will do is, first hit it will do, I believe, defense break. Second ability, or so second hit it will do branding, and a third ability it will just do. Let me restart that. First hit, you'll do defense break. Second hit, you'll do branding. Third hit, you do large damage. All right, that's how the hits or hit order will go. Now the alternative is Magic Bullet Madness. So this one, it would attack random enemies 5 times, and each time an enemy is hit, that enemy will take more damage. So obviously this is good for single target areas. So this is good for, you know, raid boss, because there's only one boss there. For Necro boss, it's pretty good because most of the time the boss will be there by itself, and it's also a multi-hit for Necro too, right? Now you can use either of these for Necro, right? They're both, both Necro and raids. They both can fulfill that purpose. Now my personal preference is Whirling Wind, because it does the debuffs. So as you know, for R5, you do want to have reliable debuffs, and therefore if you build the Homunculus to have debuffs on all three skills, then he's always going to be contributing something, right? Not just damage. If you can cover branding, slow, and HP block already quite well on your other units, then fine. You feel free to pick Magic Bullet Madness if you want, but I think Whirling Wind's a good all-round ability to pick, but it's up to personal preference, and you can build either way. You know, you can use it for Necro and raids, like I no matter what you pick on this. But yeah, I would recommend to pick the branding one at least, though, for the win version. Now along the bottom path, you have Shock Ray Destroy. All right, so instantly you can see this is going to be a PvP path. So So this one is heal block plus destroy. I think that's a pretty good synergy wise, because not only are they, you know, losing HP to the destroy, but they can't even heal up, right? Well, it's harder for them to heal up. So so this is already looking at a PvP build. So keep that in mind when you look at the next abilities. So on the second ability, you have a choice between Lightning Magic Bullet Destroy. So this one is obviously the destroy version of this. By default, it has a chance to stun, 50% chance, and you compare that to the alternative, which is a guaranteed stun. Okay, now personally I like guaranteed stuff, right? I like the guaranteed stun here, so I would pick this one. But that's not to say that this is bad, right? Because this is still destroying HP, it's guaranteed in that sense. And this one I feel is a personal choice, right? They both can work. If you're okay with losing the RNG factor on this one for additional destroy, you can do that. But he already destroys on the first ability, and you can destroy on the third ability as well, which you'll soon see. So I would personally pick the reliable stun. It single target as well. But yeah, it's up to you. Now, the third abilities, you have a choice between Sharp Wind, which is the destroy ability that I was talking about. So this is kind of similar to Beth's old third skill, except it doesn't do the debuffs. But it does destroy a fair chunk of HP. So it's good for Guild Wars offense. I mean, you can't use it for defense, obviously. But it's good for offense because in Guild Wars, you can drag out the battle as long as you want. Because there's no tower to hit you. And you don't have a time limit either, right? Because you generally have... Well, for most guilds, you're going to have like 12 hours to do your war. So you have all the time in the world to like, you know, take your time on Guild Wars. And if you're taking your time... It's good to destroy the HP to make it easier in the long run, right? If you're running a very tanky team. So this path, you'll probably build the Wind Homunculus as a bruiser type. Now, the alternative is Soul Shot. So this one is similar to Raki's third skill, which is a... it does a lot of damage, and anything that dies to this can't be revived. Now, I don't recommend this because the units that you're gonna... want to use this like this anti-revive thing on is going to be things like Perna, right? Well, Perna is the main one that wants to have an anti-revive ability. So that's why Raki is good against Perna, is because it's neutral element and she won't have trouble like glancing to, and you can reliably kill a Perna with it, right? But Wind Homunculus does not have that same luxury because it's opposing element. But it's good against things like Eladril compositions where they're not running a fire threat, right? So you could use that against that sort of a team, but I feel that the destroy version is still good against that team anyway, right? So because if you destroy the HP and Eladril revives that unit, then they're going to revive with less HP anyway. So in the long run, like, because that team's pretty much going for the long game, right? Because they're going to run probably one DPS and two supports. So like Eladril plus another healer. So a very common one is Fio, Eladril, Chasun. So in that team, they're going for the long game and just wear you out. So if you're going to... I would say against that sort of team, you would run this build. But you can use this one if you want to. Because as long as you can manage to pop the Endure first, and then use Soul Shot to kill them afterwards, or at least the Field Mars, then he won't come back from Eladril. So it's a personal choice, but I would say Sharp Wind is a bit better for PvP purposes. Alright, so just in summary, alright, just to go back real quick. So top path of Fire Homunculus, good for raids. Mostly for raids and also for arena and Guild Wars offense. All right, it's good for that. It's good single target damage, and you have an AoE alternative too if you need that. The bottom path, this top bottom path here in the middle is good for raids. The bottom path is good for Necro, right? It's got a lot of multi hits. For the Water Homunculus, the top path is good for like trash waves, right? Like things like TOA, Firemon farming, and this bottom path here is good for dragons and giants. You can also pick this one as an alternative as well. You don't specifically have to go for this one, but I'm just talking about like going for this third skill, that path. Now down here, Frostwind and also Ice Explosion, these are like TOA specialist trees. I would recommend you to go for the Frost Wind because it's a guaranteed freeze. And the Wind Homunculus, this top path is great for raids. Actually, the whole tree in this itself is good for raids, and you can also use it for Necro too. This bottom path, all of it is PvP based. I would recommend you to go for the guaranteed stun and then the destroy, which is like universally good against like a lot of comps. I should add that the anti-revive, if they're running just double healer support, then this is not as good. But the destroy one is good against like double healer plus like say Field Mars. Alright, so that's all the homunculus in summary and also in quite a long detail. I thought that I would get through this quicker, but so I hope that is helpful for you guys. If you have any further questions about the homunculus, feel free to ask me in comments, and as usual, I'll get back to you as soon as possible. So, good luck with your homunculus farming. I'm sure you'll probably be doing it a lot more because of appraisal stones, which you need the magic crystals from, and you'll get excess elemental crystals to use on homunculus. So that's it from me. Thanks guys. Thanks again for watching, guys, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.